my mother works in the government sector. She's a medical officer. My father is a complete opposite. He works for the private sector. He's been in the private sector all his life. He at one point of his career joined a multinational, which was a local manufacturing company, which is where I think he wanted to venture into his own business and start manufacturing something locally. In 1993, if I'm not mistaken, he opened the company, and he and my mother both started manufacturing toilet care products for hotels. He was always in the leisure industry. My father was always affiliated with the hotels and leisure aspect. So I guess it was just walking the path for him. He just joined in, and because he knew most of the managers and the GM, so it was easy for him to sell what he was doing, and he was very good at it. And we started off as a cottage industry, which started at home. So 25 years later, we have grown. We have grown to, I would say, a larger scale. We have 45 staff, and we have both male and female working for us. And we encourage the females to join in more. Well, my family is at large, consists of very strong and empowering women. As I told you, my mother works for the government sector, and my father always as a child showed me the path to take, and he would always direct me in the way that I should. So I was always at a young age encouraged to take over the business, but they would show me the path to take. And as a girl, my parents never showed me that you are not able to do something. They always encouraged us to be able to take over whatever we do and take it on as we can. So if we were given a task, it was always we had to finish it. But as a girl, I learned to be strong and to always go there and get it. Whereas in any other family, you know, the girl would have got a backseat. Whereas my father treated us both equally, and which made, I feel that I joined in at a very young age, and my father guided me through most of it. And when it was time to take over, I think I was ready, and I'm ready to take it to the next level as it comes. What differentiates my company, Ranali Marketing, from my competitors is that we're a 100% local manufacturing company. We only import what we can't source in Sri Lanka. So whatever we can source locally, we try to source it, like the essential oils, the main raw materials, etc. We also try to be as environmentally friendly as possible. We have quite a few products that are marine friendly and human friendly. Even if you use it on your skin, we don't use a lot of chemicals on them, so that it's not harmful to the humans. Whereas I think most of my competitors bring it down from China, and I feel that importing something means that our foreign currency is leaving this country. And I would say we should be encouraging, in my opinion, we should be encouraging local manufacturers to actually invest and start their own business rather than bringing something from abroad and sending the money out. We are already exporting to Maldives and to Dubai, and we have a large presence in the Maldives. Comparatively, Dubai we go through an agent and a few companies that we are allowed to go with. I meet a variety of people on a daily basis, and different people bring in different thoughts and needs that they come with. So I have learned to deal with different people from different countries, different aspects, and given me a lot of patience, really, because some of the foreigners that come in, you have to be very patient how they speak, because you don't understand them, or we speak too fast and they can't understand us. So mainly I would say it has taught me a lot of patience and to be calm. It's always an early start for me. I like to get to office before everyone else, so I'm first in office generally. I like to get through my day, sort out my meetings, and prepare myself for the walk-in clients that walk in on a daily basis. So I'm prepared. And also, as you know, as I told you, I've been geared to take over. So I handle not only the clients, I also handle the production, which is the main aspect. So each hotel, as I told you, caters differently. So I would have to have my hands on a daily basis on how each hotel would say the generic, what we've been supplying for a long time wouldn't be a problem, but the ones that we are new and they need something different or something innovative, I would always have to come in and take charge of that and see how it goes. I try to make time as much as possible. I try to be there for all the important things like school plays, football matches, etc. But time also is a limited factor, but I try to drop in during the day and pick them up from school so that I have a little bit more time with them. If I come early from work, I would sit and watch a cartoon or have a chat with them. But I try to make a phone call every day, at least twice a day, so that most of the time they can tell me what has happened in school, so that we are always connected to each other. They are very close to me, both boys, we sleep together, but at the time, the factor of timing sometimes it's very difficult for me to manage it because I'm not here in Colombo sometimes, go out station, and if I am here, then I try to. I would say patience, calmness, and actually I think because I like this job, I like what I do, so it's mainly that. The key quality I think is the fact that if you like what you do, everything else just comes in place, I would say. I can multitask. I'm really good at the multitasking. And I can deal with different situations at the same moment. I have two phones, and which helps me to communicate with office and the client at the same time if I'm not in office, but if I'm in office. I tend to attend to everything hands-on, so as a multitasking would be my main skill, I would say. Well, when I took it over from my dad, we were in a smaller premises where we couldn't manage the staff. And so I was the one who initiated that we shift out, really. Because, as you know, it was a family-run business, and my mother and father ran it like their own little house, I would say. But we ventured out, and we moved into bigger premises. We allocated different spacing for different products, like the soap manufacturing, the shampoo is separated, and the staff is separated. So I would say that I brought in that change. And I brought in an office where we had an HR, we had an accountant, and we had someone separately answering phone calls. Whereas all this was done by my father. And if he was not available, I was. Changes were brought in because we were growing, and we didn't realize we were growing because we were in that small premises. Where as soon as we moved out, we realized that there was a lot of potential there. So I wanted people to realize we were not this small little cottage industry. We have grown. We had ISO, we had GMP, we had all these certificates, and we had all our products, all our formulations came from Germany. We have been supplying the hotel industry for the last 25 years, and we've had stability here, and we have been giving a really, really good product, whereas nobody knows about it. So I wanted people to know about it mainly. And we never advertised, actually. We've never advertised anywhere. Until I joined in and we started giving at least those magazine advertisements. My dad and mom never believed in it. They always thought that it was bad to advertise or things. But now I think they've realized that. We've increased most of our sales through that, I would say. We did up our website completely differently, and our approach to it was different. So I guess that helped a little bit. I wouldn't say fully, because my dad did a lot of it. I'm just hearing what he started. As I kind of find it really hard to find time, but when I do, I try at least to go for a 45-minute walk on a daily basis, which is very difficult because waking up is not one of my strong suits. And I also try to eat healthy. I love rice, so I have rice for lunch, and I try to manage the other two meals with it, with the home cooked meal. Very important, I would say. For a working woman, R&R is the most important thing at the end of the week, at least once a week you need it. If not, I feel you need to get out of that work environment, the household environment, and have that time for yourself. You need it. Oh, that's a good question. Well, I read a lot, and my friends and my family, we meet as often as we can, and we have conversations on different levels, like about politics or economics, which keeps your mind stimulated into different, because as in the industry that I'm in, I need to know about all of that. If I've had a really bad day, I take a step back, I have a coffee, and I rethink what I did wrong and give it a different approach and try till I get it right. If it's a bad day, that means I have to redo what I have done and make sure that it comes right, because in my industry, you can't just say it's a bad day and give up, because you have to find a different approach and make sure the client is satisfied. If the client is not satisfied, the business is no more. Because there are so many competitors, so they can switch to anyone they want. The reason they come to us is for a reason. So I have to make sure that reason, they stay with us. I like fiction and thriller. I think it brings in the suspense and keeps it going. I like romance, but I think I prefer the fiction and thriller better, but I really don't get around to reading that. But I do try very hard, at least before I go to bed, to read a chapter or two. But the thing is, when you start on a chapter or two and you don't want to keep it down, so it's not easy to start reading. But I love it. I love reading. Well, at the recent, I love the movie that has come out, Me Before You, is something I really love. I like that whole, the way it came together and how she changes from what that little girl who was just running about to taking care of a sick patient. But then, as you can see, that came out some time ago. I've not really had the time to watch anything new. But I do the cartoons generally, at least once a week with the kids. Tom and Jerry is my favorite, I would say. All-time favorite. I would say love what you do, because that's the most important thing. And never ever think you can't. You can. Whatever you want, you are able to do, and you have to just make sure you set yourself for it and go there and get it done. Because as in, I would say, from this in the Asian region, Sri Lanka, we have a lot to be thankful for. We have a lot of women who are in high positions. We've had a president who has been, and a prime minister, and I would say that is more encouraging to know. And as a woman, I would say we should take that into consideration. Nothing is impossible if you plan your day and make sure that you go through it as you want. It's up to you. Everything at the end of the day is in your hands. If you are able to take care of your children and your husband, you're able to do this as well, I would say.
Need to be better informed? Get the Daily News app free on your mobile phone. Visit apps.lakehouse.lk and download today. News worth knowing from Sri Lanka's national newspaper. Daily News. Be better informed.